And so I want to talk about a particular use case that we used. We are trying to build as many Z degrees as we can, trying to infuse OER through our online courses and programs. And so in that process, I helped develop a theater history textbook last summer with the help of a faculty member. We pulled materials from the public domain and put that up there. Unfortunately, when you're pulling those kind of like bare minimum texts, you don't have access to the annotations that make the text make more sense. That's the kind of thing that you might see in a Norton or an anthology. And so as we launch this book, part of the work of integrating this OER is making sure that there is supportive content available for students to help understand. And Hypothesis is kind of this great tool to add to the book while also helping students unpack and understand it. So in the semester that this was implemented, students were able to ask questions in line and have the faculty add more context to these like historic plays that they are reading. They were able to have conversations about how it was staged and share clips, video clips of the scenes as they've been interpreted by various modern play companies. And so all of those things kind of compounded together to make this really interactive experience and really leverage the OER. And so we find it to be a really complementary tool for OER. And it can be helpful in identifying those kind of pedagogical gaps as well. So the faculty member also wrote little introductions to each section of the book. And in those introductions, she kind of explains what's the philosophy behind why we're choosing these plays. Well, oftentimes it's just based on the canon. It's the way we've always done it. And that prioritizes certain viewpoints and perspectives over others. And it limits the scope. And so she also seeded the book with questions to have students think through why are these decisions being made, and then have conversation in the actual introductions to the plays about how these decisions are being made and how we can expand the canon to be more inclusive. So we're not just getting this really limited worldview, even though the scope of the course was still limited, right, with only being 7 weeks. And things like that. So we were really excited to see it work really well. The faculty member reported finding it to be way more engaging than the discussion boards. As a part of implementing it, she didn't want to go entirely away from discussion boards. So what was really cool was to see the contrast between the weeks. And she's like, it was just so obvious. Like the discussion boards were less engaging, less interest, less student writing, less replies, as opposed to the annotation weeks where they were just talking together in the play itself.